Are you okay? Do you want to stop?
No. I need to go back. Right now.
Uh-oh. Oh dear.
Sean?
Of course. How could I have forgotten?
You want to share with the rest of us?
Rodrigo Borgia is elected Pope in 1492, which means Ezio's greatest enemy is now also the most powerful man in Italy.
Always wanted to visit the Vatican.
Well, your luck's in, Desmond. Happy days. Because that's exactly where you're going.
Fascinating. Absolutely fascinating.
What is it, Leonardo? What does it do?
I could no more explain this than explain to you why the Earth goes around the Sun.
You mean the Sun around the Earth?
It's fabricated with materials that shouldn't exist. And yet, this is clearly a very ancient artifact.
The Codex refers to it as a piece of Eden.
The Spaniard. He called it the Apple.
Like Eve's Apple, of forbidden knowledge. Are you then suggesting that this thing... This must never fall into the wrong hands. It would drive weaker minds insane.
No doubt the Spaniard will be relentless in his desire to gain it back.
Ezio, you must protect this with all the skills we have taught you.
Take it to Forli. The citadel is walled, protected by cannons, and our ally controls it.
Who is this ally?
Her name is Katarina Sforza.
You don't say. I think I may enjoy this mission. Thank you for everything, my oldest friend.
Leonardo, Ezio tells me you travel often to Milano. I have a grand villa in Toscana. You must come visit me there.
Well, well. Look who it is.
Madonna.
I thought when we met you were a bit special, but... an assassin? Walk with me, caro. You're going to love Forli. The cannons in our citadella alone go back 100 years. The artifact will be quite safe there.
Forgive me. But I've never heard of a woman ruling her own city before. It's very impressive.
Well, it was my husband's before, of course. He died.
Oh. Sorry.
Don't be. I had him killed.
Oh.
We discovered Girolamo Riario was working for the Templars, making a map of the locations of the remaining Codex pages.
I never liked the goddamn son of a bitch anyway. He was a lousy father, boring in bed, and a pain in my ass.
Please, leave me alone!
Look!
Mio Dio!
Oh, no!
Run!
Aspetta! What's happening?
They came as soon as you left the city walls, signora. The city is under attack.
What? By who?
The Orsi brothers, signora.
Oh, sangue di Giuda.
Who are the Orsi?
The same canaglia I hired to kill my husband.
It's the Spaniard, of course. The Orsi have no worldview bigger than their purse.
But how could he know where we were taking the apple before we even knew?
Because they're not here for the apple, Ezio. They're after Riario's map.
Basta with your map, Nicolo. My children are inside. Oh, porco demonio.
First, a gentle hand, a touch of flesh, and amputations. Your man was first, of course.
Already inside! Double-crossing bastards!
Is there another way into this place?
Aspetta! Perhaps yes. There's an old tunnel under the western wall from the canal.
Bene. I'll be right back.
Hey! You!
Yeah, I'm talking to you! You spineless dogs! You occupy my city, my home! You think I'm going to stand here and do nothing about it? How about I come up there and take your valley off?
Don't be shy.
Get Giannori, stati attenti! Bandit sighted at the crossroads to Bologna!
When you break the rules, we break you!
I'm did this? Where is the key?
Leave this place! Madmen! All madmen!
Get him!
Someone saw the fight, surely?
Come forward! Radia 10! All members of the fraternity of San Paolo!
Ora!
Last word for your woman.
Taviano,
Forgive me, Signora. They were playing outside when the attack began. I don't know where they are.
Reinforcements from the mountains! They are breaching the citadel!
Ezio, don't let those bastardi get in here!
With me!
Enough of you left to bury!
Caterina! Caterina, sforza! I know you're in there! I have something you may want back! Are you missing any children? And Ezio Auditore! What a pleasant surprise!
I take it you would be the Orsi brothers.
Ludovico!
And Checco! At your service!
Basta! Where are my children? Let them go!
Of course, Signora. We'll happily give them back for something of yours. A certain map.
And a certain apple, brother.
See, a certain apple indeed. Or shall I slice your baby's necks ear to ear?
Bastardi! You think you can threaten me? I'll give you nothing! You want my children? Take them! I have the instrument to make more!
When you change your mind, they'll be in the village outside the city. You have 1 hour.
Caterina, no. I can't ask you to sacrifice your children.
Nobody's sacrificing anything. Go get them back for me, Ezio.
Si. You have my word. The apple needs to remain in the citadel. Keep this safe.
Checco and Ludovico Orsi.
Bored with their leisurely life in the countryside, the Orsi brothers decided to spice things up a little. They started a money-lending business that was extremely successful, mostly because they killed anyone who didn't pay them back. Then, Caterina Sforza hired them to murder her Templar husband, Girolamo Riario, which they did in true cavalier fashion. They rode up to his palace, waltzed into the dining room, stabbed him in the chest, ransacked the estate, and left his naked body in the center of town. According to Abstergo's files, Rodrigo Borgia, after escaping from Venice, offered to pay them for the recapture of the Peace of Eden. And, of course, Caterina's head. It was the Orsi brothers' idea to kidnap her children. I ask you, what has this world come to when the rich go so bad?
And mine. I'm getting bored. Don't you have anything to do while I wait for you to die? Grazie, grazie, messere. But my brother, they're holding Ottaviano at the lighthouse.
stop acting like a baby.
Where are your balls?
Katerina was a fool to send you.
Or are you the fool, dying for a handful of change? Was it worth it?
More than you know. The Maestro gains his prize because of me.
Muori col tuo orgoglio, per quanto vale. Requiescat in pace.
Grazie, signore!
Noble prices for noble wares. Armor fit for a man.
What are you doing out here?
Sorry, Ezio. I'm so sorry.
What happened?
It was a trick. To lower our defenses.
As soon as you left, they attacked again. Checco Orsi. He has the apple.
What? No! Where is he?
We chased him out here. But the bastards escaped into the mountains.
I'm going.
Come here.
So, you have your prize again.
Was it worth it? So much bloodshed.
A prize of such value. It will not remain yours for long.
We shall see. Che miseria nascono dall'avidità. Requiescat in pace.
Ezio, thank God you're back with us. Are you all right? What happened to you?
I don't know.
One of my guards had the luck to find you in the hills, next to Checo Orsi's dead body.
See, that I remember. Wait, there was a third man. He took the apple.
Who?
He wore a black robe, like a monk. And I think... missing finger. See, Katerina, I have to go right away.
Of course. Then you will need this as well.
The map Niccolo spoke of. Your husband.
Ex-husband, mio caro. He swore he'd uncover the locations of all the Codex pages. You will recover the apple, but you will never find the vault without this. You know, there is an abbey in the wetlands near here. Where I've seen monks wearing black robes. I'd start there. Now go. Find us a stramaladetto monk.
I think I'm going to miss you, Katerina.
Oh, I know you will.
Laggiù! He's there, huh?
Sweet, huh? Bravo, signore.
Get him!
Ah!
One deal, fine. A little discipline won't hurt.
Blessings on you, brother.
Grazie. I wonder if you can help me.
What do you see?
A monk in black robes who lacks one of his 10 fingers.
Well, Brother Guido has only 9 toes. You sure it wasn't a toe?
Quite sure.
And then there's Brother Domenico, but it's his entire left arm he's lacking.
Again, quite sure it was a finger.
Now wait a moment. I do recall a black-robed monk with 9 fingers. Yes, of course. When we had our last San Vincenzo's feast at the Abbey.
Yes, I know the place. I'll try there. Grazie.
Go in peace, brother.
I always do. Excuse me, brother. I wonder if you can...
Unholy demon! Get away!
What's wrong?
You're the one who killed Brother Stefano! Brothers, the killer of monks has returned!
Stay back!
Please, no! I don't want to die!
I only kill those who kill others. And your brother Stefano was a killer. I'm sure you are no such thing. Now, listen to me. I'm looking for a black-robed monk who's missing a finger.
Missing a finger, you say? Do you mean, like, Fra Savonarola?
Savonarola? Who is this? You know him?
I did. He was one of us, for a time.
And then?
We suggested he retire to a hermitage for a good long time.
I'm afraid to say his retreat has come to an end. Where would he have gone?
Oh dear. Santo Spirito? In Firenze? It's where he studied. Perhaps it's where he would return.
I thank you. Go with God, brother.
Girolamo Savonarola, a Dominican friar from Ferrara, this man took his job seriously. He saw the excesses of his age, the rich stomping the poor into the dirt, the priests selling indulgences to the populace, and he went insane. Calling himself an instrument of God, Savonarola descended on Firenze. His sermons sent people into frenzies. He demanded an end to all personal property, to all progress, a return to Eden. Knowledge became the enemy. And he could erase it all with the Peace of Eden at his command. Books, paintings, musical instruments, he burned everything in the bonfire of the vanities. History unraveled as his legions took control, and Firenze descended into darkness.